Hello. So what I have here is a APC backup battery. This is a 650 VA, 360 watt. It says 67 minutes runtime for PC loads. And I'm going to talk about connecting that to the Synology NAS. So what I have here is a DS718 Plus. And I have a... I'll put a link in the description to this exact UPS on Amazon. I'll have my affiliate link. And if you like this video and you decide you want to purchase this one, you can click that link and it helps me out a little bit and doesn't cost anything extra. And I'll also put a link to my playlist with other Synology videos. So if you aren't familiar with these UPS devices, most of these are have a lead acid battery, a sealed lead acid battery, which is kind of similar to a car battery in a way. And you plug in your computer to this, and if your power goes out, it automatically switches over to the battery. And if the power comes back on, it switches back to power. So there are a couple different models here. I like to use for my my network router. I have one of these that does not have a USB connection on it, which is here. It's a USB data port, and then. Because it doesn't have that capability. But if you're hooking up to a computer, it's nice to have this USB data port. So this will plug into your computer and it will shut down your computer after a certain amount of time if the power goes out. So it looks like there's a certification certificate thing here. And we need to open up the bottom and connect the battery. These come disconnected. Sparked a little bit there. Okay. And we can pull the sticker off. Like there's also a little sticker here. This has a neat feature. It has a kind of like a USB charging port here. So if your power went out, you could say plug your phone in there for an emergency. And the instructions here. This packet has the USB port or USB cable. So this here will plug into the side here, and then this will plug into either the front or the back of the NAS. So most people I imagine will plug this into the back. Then this plugs in the wall, and then you'll plug your power adapter from your Synology into one of these battery ports here. So this one has five battery ports, and these are just regular surge ports. So if the power goes out, these will be powered. These two will not. So, and you can read through the directions. There might be a couple different modes on here to do some things. Not real sure. Like you might have to hold this down to reset it or something. I'm not sure. Like, cause I think you can mute it, because these things will often beep when the power goes out. So I'm going to look through that real quick and I'll let you know. Okay, so I read through this real quick. So you can press this button to turn it on, and then to turn it off you hold this down for 2 seconds. If the power goes out, this will beep, and you can just press this once real quick and it will mute that alarm. So, and they put the delay in there so you don't accidentally shut it off. So hold it down for 2 seconds to shut it off, and hit it once to mute that. So once you know your power's out, you probably don't need to be reminded all the time. You'll probably be in the dark. So I'm gonna plug this into the NAS, and then we'll look through the interface on how to configure this. Okay, so I have the DS718. The power of it is plugged into the UPS. I have the USB cable connected between the UPS and the DS718, and I have the UPS plugged into the wall. So I have everything plugged in together, and I've started it up, and I've logged into the Disk Station Manager. And to enable this, we'll go to Control Panel, and we need to go to this Hardware and Power down here. Oops, let me go back. If you're not seeing that, you want to toggle between Advanced Mode and Basic Mode. So you're typically in Basic Mode, you click Advanced Mode, and Hardware and Power will show up. If we click on that, you'll see these tabs here for General, Power Schedule, Hard Drive, Hibernation, and UPS. On Power Recovery, we want to check the Restart Automatically After a Power Failure. Then we want to go to UPS, and we'll say Enable UPS Support. And here you can change the time before the disk station enters safe mode. So once the power goes out, the clock will start counting down. And you could say, shut it down after, say, 10 minutes. But what I like to do is just say until low battery, which is the default. So it will stay on as long as possible. When the battery gets too low to support the disk station, it will shut the disk station down. Because oftentimes it seems like power will go out for just a few minutes and then it'll come right back on. So we've enabled UPS support. We want to shut down the UPS when the system enters safe mode, so make sure that's checked. There's this Enable UPS Server. So we don't want this checked, but I'll show you what this is. We can go in here and enter in the IP addresses of permitted disk station devices. So say you had two or three of these plugged into one UPS. There's only one USB cable connection between the UPS and the NAS device. So the one disk station will get the message from the UPS that the power's out, and then this can transmit that to the other NAS devices, and it will tell them to shut down. So that's networked UPS server. So we're going to uncheck that, though. And then we can hit device information here. And it says the manufacturer's American Power Conversion, or APC. It has the model. The status is connected. The battery's charged to 93%. And it has the estimated battery life. I think that's what that says. Estimated battery time. Yeah. So you want to check that to make sure it's plugged in correctly. Once this is done, we can hit apply. And now if the power goes out, it will shut down, it will alert the NAS that the power's gone out, and it will shut it down when the battery's low. So what I'm going to do here is I'll simulate this. Let's see, I hit apply. And we'll close this. It says changes are not saved. Maybe I probably didn't save this on the general page, maybe. Let's try and close it. Okay, I'm gonna leave. I think I have everything saved. Yes, okay. So I'm going to unplug the UPS from the wall, which will simulate a power outage. We should see this. The notifications in here should come up and say that it's been disconnected. So I'll unplug that. So the power is unplugged to the UPS. And you'll see here it says system event, the UPS device connected to DS718 has entered battery mode. So I will also have a notification in my email. Now I have another video. I'll link to my Synology playlist down below, but I have a video on setting up email notifications on your Synology system, and if you have that set up properly and your power goes out, you will be notified
So that's kind of a nice feature. And now I'll plug this back in. We'll see what happens. Okay, it's plugged back in. So in just a second here, we should see a notification. May need to refresh this. Okay. It says a UPS device connected to the DS718 has returned to AC mode. So I also received two emails saying that it was disconnected and reconnected. So if I were not home right now and the power went out for a few minutes, assuming my internet is still up. So you obviously would need your internet also on a backup battery device. Then it would let me know that the power is out. So, you know, if this is just in your home, it may not be a big deal, but if it's in an office, you may need to contact some people, to let them know the power's out. I don't know. So, but if you have any questions, about this, please leave them in the comments. And again, I have a link in the comments or in the description where you can buy this on Amazon. It's my affiliate link, and that really helps me out a lot if you use that link. Please hit like if you like this video, and thanks for watching. Goodbye.